If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture. So today again, I will be taking 5 questions from question number 66 to 67, 68, 69 and then 70. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions.
In question number 66, it is asked the total power dissipated in the circuit shown in the figure. So as you can see in the circuit, this is given 10 ampere, this is given 2 ampere. So 8 ampere will be current flowing through this, and then again 2 ampere, again 10 ampere current will be flowing through this. And this is nothing but a voltmeter. Voltmeter across the load is connected. So a voltmeter is connected, so you will neglect this current through this path. You will consider it is ideal voltmeter, no current it is taking. So this 10 ampere is flowing through the load also, because it is simply a voltmeter. Actual circuit is this one, without this voltmeter. It is just connected to measure the voltage. So the power consumed in the circuit is given as, you can see the power dissipated in the circuit is 1 kilowatt. So when where power dissipates in only in resistors. So that absorbs power. So what is the power you can say here? See here, the power 1 kilowatt, 1000 is equal to I square R, 2 square into 1 plus here I is 10, 10 square into R. So if you solve it, you will find R equal to 9.9. So once you know R, then you can easily find out this voltage, this, because this voltage is given. So voltage equal to I into Z. So I am interested only in magnitude. So you will tell magnitude of this one, that is 9.96 plus JXL. Magnitude of this one multiplied by 10 should be equal to 200 volt. Now I think you can easily solve it. Your magnitude is 9.96 square plus XL square is equal to 20. If you solve it, you will find XL is equal to 17.3, and that's your answer. In 67, what they are asking, an incandescent lamp is marked 40 watt 240 volt. This is marked as 40 watt 240 volt. If the resistance at room temperature, that is 26 degrees room temperature, at room temperature it is 120 degree. The temperature coefficient of the resistance is this one. Then an on state, the filament temperature in degree will be, because in on state your filament will be, temperature will be very high, so accordingly your resistance will also be very high. That's why this temperature coefficient is there. So if you see the bulb rating, you can calculate the RT there, that is at that particular temperature when the bulb will go and give 40 watt. At that temperature, what is the resistance? That is V square divided by 40. So you will get it 1440 ohm. Now at room temperature it is given 120 ohm. So obviously this other this huge current resistance has come due to the temperature. So what is the formula? It was RT. If I start with any RT2, means you start at a point from 26 degrees, so R26 plus your temperature coefficient, that is 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 part degree, and what is the degree that has increased? T minus 26. This into 1 plus this. 1 means original 1 plus this much into RT. What was there in 120 into 3? So this is the formula. You can remember RT is equal to R0 1 plus alpha into T. This was the formula for temperature coefficient. Resistance at T temperature, if it is, it is R0 is the given temperature. Here it is at given at 26. So 120 multiplied by 1 into 1 plus T minus 26 into 4.5. 10 to the power minus 3, RT is given 1440. Now you can easily solve it. If you solve it, you will find RT is equal to 2470.44 degrees centigrade. So easy, simple, this formula, RT equal to R0 1 plus alpha T. Alpha is the temperature coefficient, T is the temperature up to how much you increase, R0 is the initial temperature, resistance at initial temperature, which is 120. The power delivered by the current source in the figure is, so if you are delivering power divided delivered by the current source, okay, this one. So if I can find this voltage, then my job is done. I can say something about this. So you can see this voltage, you already know this is 1 volt. Do you know this voltage? This voltage, if you see this node has a volt source connected it. If there is a volt source connected it, then we say this becomes a super node, including that adjacent node. This becomes a super node. This was the concept of super node. If you connect a voltage, suppose a voltage source is connected between two nodes, and this is your grounding node. So If it is connected with grounding node, then no issue, because this voltage is fixed 1 volt. But here it is not connected with this ground directly. Between these two nodes it is connected. Here was 3 node, 1, 2, 3. So between 2 node, 1 voltage source is connected. This is grounded, so that's why we don't count it. So it becomes a super node. In case of super node, we don't write separately equation for this. We will write one common equation for this. So if I applied this, suppose this voltage is, this is 1. So what is the difference? And this is, suppose this is my VA, and suppose this is VB. So what is the relation between these two branch? If you say this voltage is V, this voltage is A, 1. So there is a difference in voltage between these two. And what is the difference? You can take, for that you can take a KVL across this path. Across this path, if you take a KVL, this voltage is VB plus minus, this voltage is 1, this is 1. So if I move along this path, then you will find a relation between this voltage I have considered as VB. So I will find a path. So if I take KVL, then if I move from here, then it is minus 1, then it is plus 1, then it is plus VB, will be equal to 0. From here I am moving along this path, this voltage I have considered VB. So from here only you will get VB equal to 0. So this voltage is 0 ultimately. So you know now this voltage, you know now this voltage. So simple nodal at VA is required. So if I applied this VA, so what is the, if I told you for nodal, you will consider all the currents are coming out of this, because it becomes a sub node. Because this becomes a node means everything should come out of from it. This is on high priority. So VA minus 1 volt divided by 1, this current, and this current VA minus VB, this voltage divided by this resistance. So VA minus this voltage is at 0 divided by 1. And because this current should go out, but it is incoming, so it is 0, 3 by 2 volt. Now if it is a 3 by 2 volt, now you can easily find here only. If it is a 3 by 2 volt and it is coming positive, that means this side is positive, this side is negative. Now you see, what I told you in case of what is load convention, this is plus minus volt, whatever, and this is the current 2 ampere. You can think it in this way also. There is a 2 ampere source and the polarity is this plus minus. So you see current is coming out of this 2 plus terminal. So what I told you, in case of resistor, you remember it this way. In case of resistor, the point through which it enters, that becomes plus, and resistor is power absorbing. So this is the load convention. If it enters through plus, it becomes absorbed. If it comes out of plus, then it is delivering. Because it comes out of plus, so it is delivering. So power delivered will be positive power it is delivering, because it is delivering actually. So 2 into 3 by 2, that is 3 watt. So this is your, the line A to a neutral voltage, this is for a balanced 3-phase star load with a phase sequence ABC. The voltage of line B with respect to line C. A line A neutral voltage is 10 angle 50. So line A neutral voltage. So you can draw it with 15 also, or you can add this 15 degree later on. Because normally what we see, we will put A as a reference, then we put V, then we put C. This is our normal, A at 0 angle. Suppose I have considered 10 angle 0. You can draw it 15 also, but for easiness, for simplicity, I am drawing this. Suppose 15 degree I will add with everything. 15 degree means actually A is here, so it is actually rotated little bit by 15 degree. So let me keep it 0, it will be easy. Voltage line B with respect to C. So BC voltage they are asking. So you have to bring this C this side, because this angle is 120, so this will be 60. So if you draw if you add this, because all are of same, so you will get this one, BBC. And you know what is the B, so this is 120, so this is 180. This is 120, so this will be 60, and this is 30, so 90. So this is 90 degree. So VBC generally gets 90 degree with respect to this. But if you increase this one by 15 degree, now what they are saying, now they are saying your A is little bit, A is not 0, A is at 15 degree. So obviously B will move little bit there and C will move little bit there. So now if you go for BC, you will find that this will be your BC. You are getting it now? ABC. So you will get something of this form, BBC. This is your C, so this is your BBC. Now you can see what will be the angle now. Obviously, because it is moved, this angle should be 90 degree. this angle should be 90 degree. You can see here, because it is moved 15, so it should also move 15. So from minus 90 to it will flow, because you are adding 15 degree here, everything is rotated, so this phasor will also get rotated. So it will be at an angle of minus 75. So obviously you can see there is option C only, and because it is 10 magnitude and it is BBC is line, so line becomes 10 root 3 angle 75. Relation between phase voltage and line voltage. In the given network, V1 is given, V2 is given, V3 is given, the phasor current I. So what will be the phasor current I? If you see the phasor current I is equal to summation of these two current. This, if I take KVL, I is equal to I1 plus I2. So now we can easily do it. This one is 100 angle 0, 100 angle minus 120, 100 angle 20. So what will be this one? If I see this, if I'm considering I1, I2 in this direction, so my V2 will be this voltage. So here voltage is V3, bottom one is V3. So here the voltage is V3, here it is V2. So V3 minus V2 by this current. So your I1 becomes, what is V3? V3 voltage is how much? 100 angle 120 minus V2 voltage, 100 angle minus 120 divided by this impedance A1. So if you do it, you will find it is 173.20 at an angle 0. Similarly, if you do I2, I2 will be this one is again V3 minus V1. The voltage here is V3. This voltage is V3 minus V1. So V3 is again 100 angle 120. This is 100 angle 0 divided by minus J1. If you do it, it is coming 173.20 at an angle minus 120. So your I will be equal to I1 plus I2. You can add these two. If you are adding these two, then it is 173.2 at an angle of 120. Always try to convert it into polar to rectangle by using cos and sine, because in calculator you may not have direct options to add these two. So you have to convert it into rectangular, then you have to add real imaginary. You should do it using cos sine. I'm not showing you, because here you can do it with calculator, but in gate exam direct shifting may not be possible from polar to rectangle. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.